Biography of James Baker III, who served as White House Chief of Staff under both Reagan and Bush administrations, laid out in a new book, The Man Who Ran Washington, The Life and Times of James A. Baker III. Author and journalist Peter Baker, he joins us now for more on the book. It's good to see you, Peter. Thanks for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Absolutely. So I just finished the book. I really enjoyed it because it paints a portrait of somebody who truly knew the city of Washington. And one of the things that I try to outline on this show is how actual power structures work here in the city. Peter, what did you learn in the writing of this book and the ever-present lessons for somebody who wants to understand how power works in D.C. that we can also see in our lives today?
Yeah, that's a great question. Thank you. It's meant to be a study in power, right? Jim Baker had all these high-level positions through a generation. He had his finger on almost every major event that happened in Washington from the end of Watergate to the end of the Cold War. He really was the sort of indispensable man for really for three or four Republican presidents, depending on how you count it. And he I think, demonstrated that you can make Washington work. At least you could in his era. Right. Obviously, things have changed today and the incentive structures have changed. But he showed that you could be advancing your party's interest, your president's interest, but still manage to work across the aisle. And that's something I think of a lost art in today's Washington.
Yeah, it certainly is. And that's part of the part I really loved about it, is whenever he was negotiating treaties and getting Democrats and others on board with that. Do you think that that is a product of a bygone age? Just in your general study, you cover the Trump administration in and out. Are we locked into this dynamic? And what was it like whenever he came on the stage and changed up the game, too?
Yeah, it feels today like everything is different, right? Look, the incentive structure has changed. In Baker's era, there was kind of a political reward for being bipartisan. There was also a political necessity. When he worked for Reagan and Bush 41 over those 12 years, they had a Democratic House all 12 years. They had no choice but to work across the aisle if they wanted to get stuff done. And so, you know, he mastered, I think, the art of the deal, if you will, to coin a phrase, right? And I think that he understood how to get something done where the other person on the other side of the table felt they got something as well without giving away too much of his own. And I think the problem today, or the challenge today, is everything is so zero sum. Today, the word compromise is just a dirty word. If you're doing something bipartisan, it must be because you're selling out, whether you're on the left or the right or whatever. And, right. And there's such a disincentive to wanting to work across the aisle.
Here's one question I had, and I read some of this in kind of your interviews with Baker and his reckoning kind of with Trump and what it all meant. Did he internalize some of the more, I mean, for lack of a better word, globalist policy that he helped architect and the backlash to that within domestic politics? Like, does he understand some of the Reagan era and the H.W. Bush policies that kind of put us on a road to where we are today? And how does he think through his decision making at the time?
Right. Well, he's definitely a committed internationalist. He believes in America taking a strong role in the world today through alliances, through partnerships with other countries, through international organizations. You know, he was the one who pushed his friend George H.W. Bush to go to the UN to get, right, endorsement of the first Gulf War, which they did successfully do. So you're right. In some ways, he is the embodiment of a lot of what Trump supporters and Trump himself kind of ran against 4 years ago and to some extent this year as well, against the notion of a global order. And so there is this backlash we're seeing, I think, today against the Baker-led Republican Party. Jared Kushner calls it a hostile takeover of the Republican Party. And I think that's one of the reasons why Baker struggled so much in these last few years to figure out how to look at both this president and the party that he spent so many years building.
Yeah, I think that's right. Anyway, Peter, thank you so much for joining us. I really appreciate it. I encourage everybody to go out there and buy the book. If you want to learn how D.C. works, this is certainly a good place to start. So thank you, sir.
Great. Thank you so much. Great talking to you.
Great talking to you. We'll have more Rising for you after this.